Well done. Now, you've done me this one favor. Let's finish what we've started. Before I can leave this cursed desert, I need several things. First, I need to fetch the item that will finance our new life in Edessa, our nest egg. It is an heirloom that has been in the Dark Vari family for generations. Then I need you to find Hrindi and bring her to me at our old meeting place in Snaketail Canyon. Please, you must do this for me. For us. Thank you.
Hello. You don't know me, but I've been following you. My name's Hrindi. That parchment you carry, it belongs to me. Esteg always meant it to be a wedding gift. Now, if you please, hand it over. You heard it right. There's no love lost between the families of Dark Vari and Zungar. But show me a close family in Apatir, and I'll show you a gnome with a conscience. What about him? I've met hundreds of men more to my liking. Only, those men didn't have what Steg possesses, the Dark Vari map. Once I learned Steg had it, I knew I had to act. I was willing to do anything, even marry the idiot. Don't ever speak my name aloud. I hate hearing it. Zungar. It's the sound of retching, of a man's skull cracking beneath a blow. Every time I hear it, I cringe. Soon I will have a new name to go with my new life. That's right. The fabled treasure map of the Darkvari family. With it, I can build a new life, shed my Zungar name, and start all over again. Perhaps I did, but he won't be able to care for me. He can hardly care for himself. Look how easily he was captured. Oh, but perhaps you're right. He doesn't deserve this, not from me. There are few gentle souls left in Apatir. I'd hate to kill the last. I'll face the world alone, then.
Be on your guard.
Are they giving you a hard time around here too? Whitestone, a boot full of vipers, this place. Can't stand it. And after everything we've done for them down in Sun Camp, you'd think they'd be more appreciative. And starvation's too good for the mayor, I say. You don't look like one of Eswin's ruffians. No, you look different, which is a good thing in this sun-blasted nothing. All right, I'll tell you. Our friend the mayor has something stashed up in his house, something worth a fortune. Can you believe that? There's something of actual value in Whitestone. I've been sent to get it, but I can't seem to find a way in. Until inspiration strikes, I'm waiting here. Keeping the ale busy. We're travelers by affiliation, but we specialize in fair exchange of goods and services. Not to say we won't steal, it's just not our stock and trade. You'll find us east of here, past the old Motus Mining Headquarters building, just shy of the seaside cliffs. You should stop by, it's quite a view. Silly question. Who doesn't hate the mayor? We travelers had a good thing going here in Whitestone. The people came to us for their needs. We had a relationship. Now Mayor Eswin says trading with travelers is illegal, and as a result the folks of Apatir won't touch us. I'm surprised they even let me into town without a fight. You're welcome to give it a go, but I can't promise you'll get anywhere. That old mansion was built by the gnomes back when they first settled the village. It's got more hidden corners than a spider web. I doubt old Eswin's even seen all of it. I doubt the old mayor has either. Maybe I'll show some initiative eventually. Until then, you're welcome to make us both look good. Bye.
What is it? Can't you see I'm celebrating? That's right. Raise a glass, friend. Let's make a toast to cowards. I've made a choice, you see. After much deliberation and many pints, I've decided to disobey my direct superiors and not perform my duties. To the fires with orders. I'm finished delivering death notices. I've seen the faces of the war dead. I've no desire to look into the eyes of their loved ones. I volunteered to be a messenger, to bring death notices from the War Council to the families of the deceased. I thought it would be welcome respite from the war. It's been its own kind of hell. I got through some of them, but by the time I reached Apatir, I was done. You would do that? It would keep me from getting discharged. For I'm not going back. Here are the death notices. Take this medicine as well. I have my own right here. Ironic, isn't it? I can face the enemy, but I can't face the families of those who fought beside me. Pathetic. Your energy will not be spent in vain. I will pay you well to do this for me, but the road will be long and fraught with grief. Goodbye.
Welcome to the Thirsty Wench. I'm Bera Grastar, owner, innkeep, and namesake. We don't get many strangers in Whitestone, at least not since motors pulled out and the mercenaries dug in. What can I get you? Don't tell anyone, but I've run out of meat to serve the customers. If these louts find out, they're liable to start a riot. Do you have any meat with you? I'll pay you good money for it. Okay, I guess that's better than nothing. I don't care where you get it, as long as it smells like meat when I place it over the fire. Hurry up with some meat, or it'll be my
Hello. Oh, look what the dust brought in.
Hello there. Normally I'd be seeking help with some of our mercenary contracts, but it looks like you've collected all of them already. I'll leave you to your work then. Not bad. The Dark Bari aren't icy killers like the Dzungar, but they can handle their own, as can you. Here's your pay. So long.
Careful out there.
Stand right there. Let me take a look at you. Filthy, weary, lonely, but special, that's for certain. We don't see folks like you in Whitestone very often. I'm Mayor Eswin Elfhelm, and I'm the closest thing to a friend you've got around here. Some call it war. I call it survival. The Modus mining interest left an empty throne when it abandoned Apotea, and now everyone wants that power. The people here, the decent, honest, hard-working people of Apotea have been through enough. Starvation, humiliation. They needed a leader, one who cares. My goals are simple. To stop the warring in Whitestone, and to rescue it from the brink of extinction. And you can help me. What do you say, partners? I like you. You're not a fool. Want to know what you're getting into? Well, I think big, but I'm smart enough to start small. I need a person who can do both. I want you to acquire something for me. Something that rightfully belongs to me. There's a man named Adith Scoria, patriarch of the most prominent mining family in Apotir. Months ago, I bought his family mine. It wasn't cheap. Now Adith refuses to surrender the property. In fact, he's gone into hiding and won't meet with me. I need you to acquire what is legally mine, the deed to his claim. Modus Mining stored all the records in its old headquarters east of the village, but the building has long since been overrun. Get that deed, and we're in business.
Keep your eyes open.
Yeah?
Yes, what is it? We're not supposed to speak with the citizens.
Joanne? You mean my wife has died?
I knew she sailed for Chlorokon, but we got so little news here in Apatir. I told her the war wouldn't last. I insisted. And as usual, I was wrong.
My wife was beautiful. She deserved better.
I only wish I could have given it to her.
I only wish I could have been there for her in the end.
Thank you for telling me.
Be on your guard.
Desert Runner stopped. She had never heard Rattlesnake speak before. His voice was a slow, nasty hiss, and that greatly disturbed Desert Runner. Please, Desert Runner. My voice is harsh, and yours is so pretty. You are so fast and so much braver than me. Can you bring me a voice like yours? Desert Runner thought for a moment and then said, I will lend you some of my voice and put it in your tail. That is why the rattlesnake clicks.
A scavenger? State your business here. Goodbye.
What is it? Can't you see I'm busy? If you're from the village, you can tell Mayor Eswin that I'm not interested in any other deals he may wish to offer. This discovery belongs to everyone, and it will not be used to further one man's agenda. Why, yes! I most certainly am! Fascinating. You seem to have stumbled upon the Commonite all on your own. Well done, my friend! Well done! If I find enough samples of this incredible resource, it may just be enough to convince Motus to return. If they do, that means Apatir has a fighting chance. Carry on with your search. My research suggests that the veins run beneath all of Apatir, so I would search the mines. Of course, you're the one who would confirm whether my research is accurate. Goodbye.
You haven't laid eyes on Rindy, have you? She is bright, graceful, like an oasis on a summer's day. I was sure she would be here. She said the stars themselves wouldn't wait as long as she would. What do you mean she's gone? Was her fear too great? Did she choose to stay behind? I had a feeling this would happen. In the end, I couldn't make her happy. That is a lie. You didn't know her as I did. You are a stranger in Apatir. You can keep the parchment. It is a map drafted by my grandfather. It reveals the locations of all Dark Vari hordes in Apatir. I don't want it. Not anymore. What good is wealth if the one you meant to share it with is gone? What good is anything?
Leave, but again Rattlesnake stopped her. I'm sorry to trouble you again, Desert Runner, but your patterns are so beautiful and my scales are plain. Can you bring me a pattern like yours? I will paint on your back with my feet, Desert Runner said. That is why Rattlesnake is decorated with diamonds.
It was then that Issa brought forth the talisman of fate and entered the marsh. This craven arena, a place of life and death. The winds carried the songs of the dying. The Maya sucked the bones of armies below the sea loam. And the mist shielded the eyes of your ancestors from the horror as the two armies clashed.
Ah!
time the bird prepared to leave. Desert Runner, you have helped me so much, and I thank you. But I still need one thing. You are a skilled hunter, and I am always hungry. You never use your wings to fly. Let me have them so I can hunt like you. Desert Runner said, I have given you my voice and gilded you with my labors. Now you would take my wings and take my freedom too? You ask too much of me, Rattlesnake. I will not help you any longer.
Yeah.